What were the diet and eating habits of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Really simple principle that I'll share with you. Less is more, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wasn't a person who would gorge. He wasn't a person who would chug. He was a person who would sip. He was a person who taught us to breathe in between our sips of water. That when we ate, that we would eat a third, a third, and a third. A third for food, a third for our drink, and a third for our air and breathing. The Prophet ﷺ was a person who taught us that food is one of the primary reasons for illness if we eat too much of it or if we eat the wrong types. The Prophet ﷺ was a very organic eater, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He ate dates, he drank water, he drank fresh milk. He was a person who would enjoy the luxuries of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He loved al-thareed, which was a meat-filled dish on buttered bread with broth. He used to love the excessive amount of soup. Some of his favorite vegetables were things like pumpkin and cucumber, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. A hadith that mentioned watermelon. He was a person who was a healthy eater. He never ate alone. And that's a really important thing. He was very social in his eating. There's no hadith where you ever hear that at any time he ever had a meal that wasn't shared with others. He ate, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, with his hands, not just because there weren't utensils. There were hadith where he ate with utensils, but because his hands, it limited the kind of quality. He taught us not to blow on our food, not to be so greedy that we can't wait until it cools down a little bit, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He taught us that the person who serves others should be the last to eat. And therefore, it was an honor to make sure that everyone was well fed and watered before a person considered their own needs. There were times where the Prophet, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, taught us to restrict food. And he would fast every Monday and Thursday, the 13th, 14th, and 15th of every lunar calendar, and of course the month of Ramadan, and other special days like Ashura in the month of Muharram. You know, the holistic approach of the Prophet ﷺ is really what is key. I'll give you three important verses that are of benefit that you can see reflected in the level of the Prophet ﷺ. Allah says, "Kulu washrabu wa la tusrifu." Eat and drink, but don't be excessive. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَعَلْنَا اللَّيْلَ لِبَاسًا وَالنَّهَارَ مَعَاشًا. I've made the night a place of repose and rest, and your daytime a place of activity. And therefore, eating at night wasn't in the habit of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That was something from the active part of our day. And third and most importantly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَجَعَلْنَا مِنَ الْمَاءِ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ حَيٍّ. I've created out of water every living thing. You and I, we need to drink much more water. The Prophet ﷺ in the authentic hadith, he said, ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. One day you'll be questioned about the excessive joys of life, the bounties of life. And he said, شَرْبَتَ مَاءٍ بَارِدْ فِي يَوْمٍ حَارٍ. One of those joys that he relishes, ﷺ, is a drink of cold water on a hot day. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel and like the videos so that you can get notified of the new releases and consider donating to this worthy cause.